Hello students, in this video we will discuss a very important topic of SQL, that is the triggers. Okay, let's start with the formal definition of trigger. These are stored programs which are automatically executed or fired when some event occurred. So triggers are generally, we didn't call it externally. Triggers are automatically executed when some event occurs in the database. So what kind of events could be there? Basically, events could be of following type. First is DML statement. As we all know that what is DML? DML is the database manipulation statement, which are generally used for changing the data in the database. So DML statement generally affect the data, not the structure of the database. So triggers could be called, or you can say the trigger could be executed during the time of DML statement, and the DML could be kind of delete statement, it could be insert or update. So these three statements will affect the data of the database, not basically the structure. So trigger could be called during the time of data manipulation statement. If we are using any kind of DML statement, then the trigger could be automatically called. Second is data definition statement. Data definition statement generally affect the structure of the data, so triggers could be called during the time of data definition statement. It could be kind of during the time of create, if we are creating a table in the database, or we are altering the table in the database, or we are dropping some table. So in that case also a trigger could be executed. And the third is during the time of some database operations, like there is any server error, then a trigger could be called, which will display an error message, or we can call the trigger during the time of login to the server, or if we are logging off our server, then with the help of trigger we could take the backup of the database, or during the time of start of the database, or you can say during the time of shutdown. So if any type of database operation is executed, then the data trigger could be called. So if any of the event will be done in the database, then the triggers could be called. Trigger can be defined on the table, view, schema, or database. As you know that table, so trigger can be defined on the table during the time of any data manipulation statement, or during the time of data definition language. It could be defined to the, if we are executing a view, or if we are defining a schema or database in which event is executed. So the event could be executed any of the following, like table, view, schema, or database. Next is trigger can be fired in two different modes. One is for or after trigger. That means we can fire the trigger during the time of database transaction or after the time of database transaction. In any of the condition, trigger could be fired. If you start that, it gets fired only after the SQL server complete all actions successfully in a specified table, then trigger could be fired. We can roll back all the earlier transaction by issuing rollback. If we are fired the trigger or using the mode for or after, then in that case we can roll back the transaction. But let's give an example. On inserting a row on a table, if we are inserting a row on a table, the trigger defined on insert operation, and if we are defining a trigger operation on the insert, then the row gets successfully inserted, and if the insert fail, SQL does not execute the transaction, because if trigger, when we are fired the trigger, we are firing the trigger during the time of insert operation only. If the insert operation will not get successful, then in that case the trigger will not get fired. So in that case we need not roll back our transaction, because only trigger will get fired only in that case when the insert operation will be executed successfully. Okay, the next is instead of trigger. Second mode is we are performing the trigger. It is not affecting the database basically. So in that case, it calls the code present in the trigger to be executed instead of the operation that caused the trigger to fire. So in that case, basically we are executing the trigger in the trigger body only. We are not firing the trigger during the time of database operation. So in case of, instead of trigger, we cannot roll back our transaction because it will automatically execute it when the trigger will be created. So instead of trigger, in case of instead of trigger, we cannot roll back our transaction because the trigger is executing in the trigger body only. We are not calling the trigger, or we are not firing the trigger during the time of any DML or DDL operation. Trigger is performing at the at its body only. So instead of trigger, in this case, insert would not happen, but the trigger get fired. So in that case, we cannot roll back our transaction. But in case of fore and after trigger, we could roll back our transaction. We can say that in fore and after trigger, transaction will only get executed if the operation of database will be successfully done. Next is benefits of the trigger. Trigger can be written for the following purposes, like generating some derived column value automatically. If we are performing the column level trigger, then we can generate some column values automatically with the help of trigger. Second is enforcing referential integrity. Referential integrity is basically related with reference key. If we are enforcing that there is some referential integrity will definitely be performed, then we can use one trigger, and with the help of trigger, if it is not following the referential integrity constraint, then we can enforcing the referential integrity with the help of trigger. Next is event logging and storing information on the table access. During the time of event logging, or if we are storing some information on the table, then we can use the triggers that is automatically called during the time of event. Is auditing. Next is synchronous replication of tables. If during the time of trigger, if we are we want that our replication of the table will automatically get generated, then we can use the help of trigger. Next is imposing security authorization. If some illegal, or we can say that if some someone who is not authorized to the database, and he or she wants to impose the security, he are respecting the security, then we can impose the security authorization using the trigger. Next is preventing invalid transaction. For preventing the invalid transaction, you could also fire the trigger. So these were the benefits of the trigger. Now let's move on to the syntax of the trigger. First is create trigger and trigger name. The first command which we have to write for creating the trigger is create trigger. So it is basically creating the trigger in the database. So we will use the statement, first keyword as create trigger. Next is trigger name. Trigger name could be any name which we are using as a trigger name, but it should be unique, and it should not be repeated in the same database. Next command is, next we will use before or after. We can execute the trigger before our database is entered in the database, or before performing some operation, or if we want to perform the trigger after the database instruction, then we can could use the keyword as after. So what we will write, create trigger name, then we could use before or after, whatever we want, then any kind of DML or DDL operation. In this case, like if we want the insert operation, if we want that trigger will get fired before or after inserting the data in our database, then we could use the word as insert. Second DML command is update. If we want that our trigger will be called before or after the update command, then we can use the update word. And if we want that our trigger will be fired after deleting something from the database, after we are deleting some row, and not some row or column, depends on if we are using the row level trigger, we are executing in the column level trigger. So if we are deleting some data, so we could use the word as delete and could fire our trigger. Next, what will we use? On table name. On which next is on. On is a keyword that you have to use, and then we will use the table name. Table name is the table on which you want to perform that your trigger will get fired. Then after the on, what we will use? We will use the table name on which you want that your trigger will get fired. Then it's for each row. That means in that case we are using the row level for the each row. That means in that case we are using the row level trigger. In if we are using for each column, then we can use in this for each row. Instead of using for each row, we could use the for each column. Then trigger body. So this is the basic syntax of the trigger. Let's start with the create trigger explanation of syntax. First is create trigger. In this case, create or replace an existing trigger with the trigger name. It will, if we are having the trigger with the same name, then it will replace the previous trigger. And if there is not the trigger with the same name, then it will create the trigger with the name trigger name. Second, before or after, this is specify when the trigger will be executed. So it will tell the time at which the trigger will execute it. If it is using, if it is triggered or if it is fired before the transaction, then we will use the word as trigger. And if we want that our trigger will fire after we will execute our transaction in the database, then we will use the word as after. Insert, update, and delete. These are the DML operation. We could use, instead of using DML operation, we could also use the DDL operation, which we have discussed in the previous slide. And the DDL operation could be like create table, drop table, and alter table. So during the time of these DDL operation, we could also fire a trigger. Next is on and table name. On is the keyword that you have to use, and next is the table name. This is specify the name of the table associated with the table trigger. So it will specify the table on which we want that our trigger get fired. For each row, this is specify a row level trigger. If we want that column level trigger, then instead of for each row, we could use for each column. That is, the trigger will be executed for each row being affected. The next is trigger body. This provide the operation to be performed as trigger is fired. If we are not performing any PL SQL and we are using our trigger body, then we have already discussed that if we are using the instead of trigger, then it will execute the trigger body, and definitely it will not get the rollback that we have already discussed in the previous slide. Now let's take one example. That if there are one given student report database in which student marks assessment is recorded. So in this case, we are using one table called student, which is giving the fields as student ID, name, subject 1, subject 2, subject 3. These are the subjects of the student, total and percentage. So through trigger, what we basically want that in such schema, we want to create a trigger so that the total and average of specified marks is automatically inserted whenever it is recorded in circuit. So in this case, what we want that total and percentage will automatically will be calculated as and when the user or the database user will insert the subject's entry. Okay. So we didn't want that we will calculate the total and percentage marks and then we will enter the data in the database. With the help of trigger, what we could do, we could automatically insert the value of total and percentage with the help of trigger. So let's see how we can do this. Okay, first of all, what we want to do, create trigger. This is the problem statement that we have to be done in the trigger. First statement is create trigger student marks. Okay, what is desired in this problem statement is, first of all, what we will do, create trigger student marks. So create is the statement, and trigger, what is trigger? Trigger is the name that we have to use. Student marks. Student marks is, what is a student marks? Student marks is the trigger name. Okay. Then what we will use? Before, insert on student. So here we are using the word as before. Okay. Instead of before, what we could use? We could use the word as after. Okay. So before inserting the data in the student for each row. So we are using the row level column. What we want to do? Set student dot total. In this case, what we will do? In the student dot total, so in this column, we will entering the addition of these subjects, so subject marks, and addition of subjects will go into the total column, and student dot percentage is equal to student dot total multiplies 3 by 100. So we are calculating the percentage here. So in percentage column, if when the trigger get fired, then it will automatically save the value of percentage into the student dot percentage column, and it will save the total marks into the student dot total column. Okay. Now, as we say, above SQL statement, we created trigger in the student database. Okay. Because student, what is a student? Student is a table on which we want to fire a trigger. Okay. In which whenever subject marks are entered, as and when the marks get entered, then before inserting this data into the database, trigger will compute those two value and insert with the entered value. Okay. So let's say what happened. When one SQL statement will execute, like insert into student values, 00 is the ID, student name, 20 20 20, so this is the marks 1, marks 2, marks 3, and in this case total and percentage is 0. Okay. But what happens is this: if we will select the values from the student database and it will execute this statement, then we will see that the total and percentage will automatically get inserted as we are performing the trigger, or we are firing the trigger in the student database. Okay. So the total marks, that is 20 plus 20 plus 20, this will be entered in the total column, and the percentage will be stored in the percentage column. Okay. So in this way, trigger can be created or executed in the database. Okay. Let's see one more example. Okay. In this case, what we are using? We are using the PLSQL statement along with the trigger. Okay. So in this case, let's see one syntax. Create is the keyword that we have to use. So in this case, we can use the create or replace command. Trigger, then we have to use the trigger name. Before, after, instead of, we can use the any of the three kinds. We can use the word as before, after, or instead of trigger. Then we can use the DML, any kind of DML statement, like, or DDL statement, like insert, update, or delete. Then we have to use of column name, insert, update, or delete. And then we can, it is the optional. If we want to use the column name, then what we will use? On is the keyword. Then table name is the table on which we want our trigger to be fired. Then we are using the word for each row. We can use the, instead of for each row, we could use the for each column. And in the previous syntax, we, after the for each row, what we were using? We were using the trigger body. In this case, if we want the PLSQL along with the trigger, then what we will can use? We can use the when keyword, after that condition, then declare, as PLSQL statement will start with declare, then we can use the declare statement, begin. PLSQL statement will get executed through the begin block. then we could use executable statement, then exception, exception handling statement. These are the optional. We could use the exceptional statement, or we could declare begin and end a CLS code statement. So let's take one example. To start with, we will using, in this case, we are using the table as customer. Okay, in the customer, we are having the six entries. That is automatically already inserted. So in this case, what we want to do, what this following program will do, this program create a row level trigger. Okay, so in this row level trigger, what we have to use for each row. Okay, because in this program will create a row level trigger for the customer table. Okay, so in this case, we are using the table name as customer. On the table customer, we want to create a row level trigger that would be fired for insert or update or delete, whatever operation you want to perform on the customer's table. Okay, that begin the example. This trigger will display the salary difference between the old value and the new value. Okay, so what we will do, create or replace trigger. We can use the word as create, or we could use the word as replace trigger. Then this is the trigger name. Whatever the value that is being we are using in caps lock on, then this is the keyword that you have to use as it is. So what we are using, create or replace trigger, trigger name, before delete or insert or update. Okay, you can use any of the one type. On customer, okay, on customer, customer is the table name. For each row, when new dot id is greater than 0, id is, what is id? Id is the column name, or we can say the primary key of customer table. Okay, so what we will use, when new dot id is greater than 0, new is again a keyword that is that could be used in the PLSQL statement. So what basically new is declaring here, new is when some new ID is inserted in the customer table and its value is greater than 0, then this particular trigger, that is display salary changes, will automatically be fired. Okay, so next is declare word that we will use in PLSQL statement. We are declaring one variable with the name of cell underscore difference, and which is kind of number type. Then we will begin our program. Let's say begin salary underscore difference. This is the variable name, is equal to colon equal to, this is the syntax that we have to use, new dot salary minus old dot salary. Okay, so whenever the new ID, whenever the some new ID will be inserted, then the salary, in salary difference, the new salary minus old salary will get saved into the salary difference variable. And with the help of dbms underscore output dot put underscore line, we could print the these values into the screen also. So we will use dbms underscore output dot put line old salary, and it is the variable name is old dot salary, new dot salary, and we are printing the value as salary underscore difference, and with the forward slash we will end our PLSQL statement. Okay, when the above code is executed at the SQL prompt, it will produce the following result. It is trigger created. Okay, now what happens after the trigger will execute? Okay, so let us now perform one more DML operation on the customer table. The update statement will update an existing record in the table. So we are executing the update command. Okay, update customer set salary is equal to salary plus 500, where ID is equal to 2. Okay, let again see the previous slide. What basically the update statement is doing, we are firing our trigger during any of these operations, we could perform the delete operation, we could perform the insert operation, we could perform the update operation. Okay, so we are performing in this example, we are executing this trigger with the help of update statement on the customer. Okay, again, let's see, we are updating the customer and setting the new value of salary is equal to salary plus 500, where ID is equal to 2. Okay, so let's say the data, in where ID is equal to 2, in case of ID, we are having the previous value as 1500, and with the help of update command, we are setting the new value as 1500 plus 500. That means it will set the new salary as 2000. Okay, so when the record is updated, we are updating the record. So what happens in this trigger? The trigger display salary will automatically will be fired, and after this update command, it will display the result on the screen as old salary was 1500, new salary was 2000, 1500, new salary is 1500 plus 500, that is 2000, and with the help of trigger display salary change, it will automatically display the salary difference as 500. Okay, instead of update command, we could also use the insert command, and with the help of insert command, we could this trigger will also get automatically executed. But in this case, if we will use the ID as 6, ID will use the ID as 7, or we are inserting some new record, then in this case, as it is the new record and the ID is given 0, so first of all, what we have to do, we have to update that particular value, and then we could calculate the with the help of trigger, we could use the find the salary change. Okay, I hope you all are aware of this concept of trigger. In the next video, we will discuss about the cursors. Okay, thank you for watching.